The ongoing heavy rains, which is causing intense flooding and destruction of crops and livestock, is said to challenge the government-sponsored agriculture insurance.
The losses are going to be significant. That actually, even despite the excessive rains, even the timing was not good. Some crops had already dried up because the rains came in a bit late. So it's not going to be a good season for them, but I trust that they have the capacity. And the average premiums being generated are in the range of 11 to 12 billion per annum, with claims being paid in the range of 5 to 6 billion shillings per annum. So that said, of course, this season is not going to be a very good one.
A cross-section of farmers now argue that the government-sponsored 15 billion shillings agriculture insurance subsidy may need rethinking.
Because from 2015, climate change came in and farmers started disappearing from the production arena. That's why you see Uganda importing vegetables from other countries. So we needed to do irrigation 100% to our farmers and to increase productivity. We needed to have a cold chain to control the quality. The production chain from the farmers to the cold chains must be thorough. So we need big capital investment in order to produce more throughout the year so that we can employ more Ugandans.
The local insurance industry, which provides cover to 180,000 farmers to date under the scheme, also believe that a little more groundwork is still necessary.
Because if we are going to deepen insurance penetration, then we must reach out to the common man. So one of the ways we want to do is to partner with the stakeholders and the consortium that is working on agriculture and make sure when we go to meet our farmers and our livestock keepers that we're not just selling agri for the crops, but we're also talking about their health, medical insurance.
Reina Ojo, NTV Business.